speak about women and intergovernability, so maybe I change completely the topic, but there are several links with the topic with your project about materials, because one of the most important and difficult problems that we have to solve when we work with existing buildings in order to save energy is to know material, is to know how the building was built, because we haven't in 100% of the case we haven't as built drawing that correspond to the reality. So this is one of the most important problems that we have to solve, and as it is not so easy to solve it, we try to solve using energy simulation and several kind of calculations. So today I'm going to present two projects. The first one is energy efficient building, that it is an Italian project funded by the Smart City cluster, and the other one is the DIMAR project it is finished a few months ago, but it is very important for us because we have a new idea for the future starting from this project. And then, actually, I don't know, I missed one word, but and then I explain you how we are working also for dissemination activities, a special kind of dissemination activity, that it is not the scientific activities like this one and so on, but I show later, and then conclusion and future works. So the energy efficient buildings project wants to work on energy efficiency building using perceived technologies starting from ICT. So all these projects are ICT projects, are not and in this case interoperability is very important, because we have to solve we have to solve a problem about interoperability between the BIM model and the energy software simulation. But we have also to solve a problem about interoperability between the sensor that we install in the building and between the real-time integration of the data that we receive, and to select the information that we receive that are normally maybe too much, because in this period that we speak every time about the big data, we have a lot of data, and in several times we don't need so many data. So this is the goal of the project. For the project for this project we are working in Settimo, that it is a city close to Turin, and we selected some representative buildings. Some are public and some are private. In order to work on this kind of problem, project is very difficult to work on private buildings, because it is not for the privacy, because it is not possible to go inside to install equipment and so on. So, but in this case, and so in this case, we decided to work on public buildings in detail, starting from the survey and the BIM model, and we use the geographic information system at the city level, working with the private buildings. So we use the information that we have in a different way. The first step is when we have to work on energy efficient building, existing building, because we work only on existing building. We have to identify the information that we need, and we have to decide the level of detail or the level of information that we need in our models. And based on this, we decide how to plan the survey of the buildings or the district. And in this case, as you can see here, we start from the collection of the information that we have, that as I introduced before, several times don't correspond to the reality. And then we realize the model for operation and for visualization in order to improve the awareness of people that use building on energy saving, but it is a very important point. And on this, for this reason, we realize the model with different level of detail based on the results that we need to obtain. And based on this, we select the information. So the first step is the survey, and the second one is to install the sensor. Why we install the sensor? Because thanks to the information that we obtain from the sensor, we are able to validate the model that we are going to do. So we use the real data to validate the model. And then when we validate the model, we are able to plan different scenario and to decide which one is the best one in relation to the building. So just a few examples. I'm going really very quick because it is also late, but several examples to show you what we do. So we use the information to realize the model, and with all the information about the windows, about the dimension, about the room, the roof, so all the elements that describe the building with the different information that we are able to have or to imagine that can be. This is an example of a very important building in Settimo because it is the library, and it is a building where people live, where people spend a lot of time. So it is a very important building for the dissemination activities, for instance. And what we do is, starting from the BIM model, we realize the building energy model, and then the simulation. And the results that we obtain are different in relation to the building. So, because we are working on different kind of buildings that are representative in the city. So we, every time in each project, we select the buildings that are different for dimension, for the construction period, for materials that used in that period, for the use of the building, and so on. And the process that we use is an iterative process that every time started from the BIM, pass to the information to the energy analysis model, and we optimize the process, and we are sure that the process, the validation is complete when the results that we obtain starting from the model are the same than the measured one. Because when we model a wall, for instance, and we don't know the stratigraphy, it is really very difficult to be sure that the wall that we introduce in the model is the correct one or not. So when the results of that we compare with the user are correct, we consider it the right one. And this is another example using different software in order to verify that the BIM model can be used by different professional people that are working on energy simulation. And this is an example of results that we obtain comparing the simulation and the real data that we receive from the sensor. I don't want to compare and to detail them because they are different building by building. But, and then we use the same model with the virtual and augmented reality in order to show the results and in order to use them, for instance, for people that have to work in operation, because the BIM model is so in the BIM model we have the architectural elements, the structural elements, and the map elements, and all these elements can be used by different stakeholder or by different technician or by different end user. So the essential point is that we use the same information several times for different goals. So the other project is the DIMAR project, the District Information Model and Management for Energy Reduction. So we pass from the building scale to from the building level to the district level, working with the, again in the same way than energy efficient building, working on the management modeling and visualization of the different data that describe the building and the district. For the different level of information. The workflow of the DIMAR project start can be read from the left to the right and vice versa. I'm starting from this domain that it is that the has the BIM domain, the GIS, the system information model, and the building management system domain. So different domains, different kind of data that are going to the DIMAR information model and that we are using in different tools in order to visualize them for different use cases based on different target users. This is a very complex workflow that means to manage a lot of information, and the interoperability is essential, as the quality of the information that we have. Because I repeat again, about the existing building, we don't know the information at the moment. We have to change the culture on this. Because when we work on a building and we realize a model, if we introduce the correct information, we can use it several times. Because don't know the information means to have a very high cost. Because every time we have to imagine, to test, to measure and so on. And this is there are not so many research that calculate the cost of the when we don't know the information. And I think that this should be an interesting project, but not in this case. The demonstrator in the DIMAR project was two. The first one in Manchester, where we selected several representative buildings in the campus, the university campus, and one in Turin, close to the Politecnico campus, where we selected different buildings. So, for instance, in this case, we worked in two private buildings. One was my flat, and the other one was Enrico Macini flat. So it was easy to install sensors and so on, and to go inside it, because in the other one, as it was before, it was impossible. So we know perfectly the cost of our energy and so on. What we did, again, we realized the model starting from the information and the survey that we did. As you can see, the models are not, so they don't contain a lot of architectural elements. The essential part, because the goal is energy simulation. So we introduce in the model only the information that are required for the simulation. For instance, sorry, if we have to work on lighting simulation, we need to know the color of the wall and of the elements that are inside and outside the building. If we work on thermal simulation, we don't need to know the color of the elements. What we need to know the stratigraphy of the wall. Instead, if we work on lighting simulation and we introduce all the information about the wall and so on, the dimension, the size of the model is so big that interoperability is more difficult. So we have to balance perfectly the essential information that you require inside the model in order to optimize interoperability, because this is one of the most important goals. This is the process that we use starting from the model using different software and different formats in order to work with a software like Energy Plus or Yes Environment. Again, the workflow is iterative as for the previous project. And this is the result. So the result is starting from the model, we optimize the information that we put in the model. And then we realize the energy model, and we compare, we receive the information from the sensor, and we compare the information from the sensor and the simulation. And based on this, we for the DIMER project, we decided three different scenarios. The first one was to change the windows, I will you because you spoke before about the windows. So we decided to change just the windows, and we obtain 16% of energy saving. And I don't remember, Matteo, where is the return of investment? Ah yes, here. Time of return of investment very long. Then to change the envelope, the general envelope of the building, again the return of investment too long, more energy saving, but it depends if the of course, this value depends on the buildings. Different buildings have completely different results. The last scenario is to change the peak shaving of the district heating. Of course, the costs are zero,
yes,
and the energy save. Save is not so high, but it is
on the city.
On the city, so it is very important. And we realize this during as a result of the as a result of the project, because one partner was Iren, and that is the partner that managed the district heating. So this is just an example how we can use the information, and then we can extend the information that we have for the building that we selected as representative at district or city level. And the results of this can be used for the policies by stakeholders that have to work on policies or human policies. And this is just a few results based, as you can see, on the construction period of the building, the percentage of the energy saving that we can obtain. About the dissemination activities, working with the smart people of the future, we like to work with the children in school and in public events like Notte dei Ricercatori and so on, because the first, so the cheaper energy saving that we can obtain is changing our habits. But it is quite impossible to change habits of people that have that are older than us. It is very simple to teach to children how to save energy, and working with them using virtual and augmented reality that again we use for these activities starting from the model, it is possible to pass to them this kind of information that are results of scientific results, but simplified for them. But I'm sure that if we would be able to measure the energy saving that they would be able to obtain, the results should be better than the refurbished, the scenario one or two of the DMAR project. So the conclusion, as a conclusion and future works, is the implementation of the workflow and the process, because two are the elements that we have to solve. To the knowledge of our real estate, if we want to manage it in a correct way, we need to know it. And the second one is to optimize the interoperability. In that case, we are using a middleware that is under developing by from Novorfit in Germany. And the other point is how to use the information of our research to pass our results to stakeholders in order to use it in the best way. Thank you very much for your attention.